Who doesn't want something for free? Today, I want to show you how to do some keyword research for free using tools that you generally can use for free. Yes, they will be limited, and yes, it will be more work than using a paid tool. But if you are struggling with your cash flow and you do want to save a few bits and pieces here and you have the time, then using a few free tools can definitely bring you forward. So let's check it out. So, the first tool I want to show you, which a lot of you may know or not, is the AMZ suggestion expander, which you can find up here. So it's just a Chrome extension. It's this one. So if you go to any Chrome browser and just type that in, you can install it to your browser bar up here. And whenever you type in anything into your Amazon search bar, this extension comes up. So it shows you what other people search for, and it shows you the auto completion extended with. That's what Amazon normally would show you as suggestions for buyers. And that's obviously all keywords before, keywords after, and everything else. So they're not in a particular order. Sometimes, yes, there are in the order where people click the first one, but it's I can't guarantee. Obviously, we're also missing out on search volume and other things. But in saying this, it will still give you a lot of nice phrases if you. Again, that's where it gets a bit more complicated or more expensive. If you want to download this straight away, you have to upload, upgrade here. But you can also just like literally use a little keyword list and write them in. Yes, it is work, but I think it's totally worth it. Because honestly, with the extension here, this is what people really look for. So what I've just noticed recently, there were a few people that typed things in and wrong over and over the time. So for example, we're looking at Buddha statue. You can see here, the first thing that Amazon suggests is actually a misspelling, a Buddha statue, which is obviously written wrong. So, but more and more people keep clicking on it. So the search volume for this particular keyword just went through the absolute roof. So from being a misspelling mistake, like around 200-400 search volume, now suddenly it's 9,000 search volume. And as you can see, Amazon does it for all of these. So people keep clicking on these, which would actually increase the search volume. So pretty cool thing for you to do is just download this extension and type them in. You find a lot of things that are completely new. It's also a really good tool to get us some product ideas. What are people looking for? That's the only tool that actually shows you what Amazon customers really type in, where everything, all the other tools are a lot of assumption and reverse engineering what sellers type into their keywords. Another free tool which I really like, so let's just go back to our pet hair remover just because I want to keep it all the same so you don't get confused. Even Helium 10 still offers you free versions, right? So your Cerebro, if you look into your Cerebro, you can use Cerebro 2 times a day for free. Loading. And then you can go here to your keyword search Cerebro, and you can use that tool 2 times for free every day. Same as Magnet, same. So I'm going to use that here as well. Unfortunately, on a free plan, you will not be able to enter multiple ASINs. You can just do one ASIN at a time, and you only get the first 50 words. But still, that's pretty great. So if we just use, most likely this is the best seller. So we just go on to this one. And we use the ASIN, which you can also find up here in the browser bar. Copy it. Pop it in here, and that's what you will get if you're using the free one. And in Magnet, at the same time, we go to pet hair remover and we do the same. So you get these for free. You can even download the lists on here, which is awesome. So here, like I said, you won't be able to do any filtering and you will only see the first 50. But again, there's a lot of great keywords in here. And the great thing about Helium 10 is, even on a free plan, if we show you the search volume, it will most likely not show you the CPR, which is a bit annoying. But at least you can see that removes pet hair is a bad keyword compared to dog hair remover versus pet hair remover. So you have a lot of keywords that you can find out with these free tools. And that's reverse ASIN based on this one. So we're going to show you, I'm going to show you another one in a second. And then there's also magnet, which is not ASIN particular, but keyword particular. So again, you won't be able to use any filters on the free version, but you can still say a lot of nice keywords that are similar, which you then could assess and check out. And obviously always check for relevance. Go onto the Amazon search page, type the keyword in and check it out. Very important. So we got all these nice keywords here. What I do, I copy them. So you can still, even on the free plan, you should be able to copy, export, and then I pop them all into my nice little keyword list. So let's just use those ones. I'm going to just copy the first ones. I copy them to my clipboard. And I just want to show you a few bits and pieces here. Perfect. So you can put the keyword list in like that. You can add a lot of them. And then later in data, if you know a little bit about Excel, you can remove duplicates, which is awesome. Why is that important? Because we're going to do a lot of things with other tools as well. So I signed up for the free plan for keyword tool Dominator, which is also a great tool. They also have an extension, which is just up here. I'm using the free plan because, to be honest, to sign up for every tool that's out there, of course you can do that, but then you're spending around $500 a month just in tools. And I do know that as a beginner, you just maybe you don't want to spend that money, or you just don't have it and you're rather invested in actual products. But in saying that, product only sells as well as you do your listing. So it's kind of like a little bit of an in-betweener. So I'm a big fan of having one great tool to use all the time, but to fill it up with little bits and pieces that are free out there. And also, most of these tools are limited. So this one you also can use, I think, 3 times a day. But we're going to put this one in here, which is our pet hair remover. It's the same marketplace, and then we have a look. Starting the search, can't do heaps here. Again, not much filtering going on. But again, it's a great keyword finder. And then I show you why I'm using an Excel sheet to keep working with it. Finding a lot of keywords. And again, in saying that, we don't need 10,000 keywords. If you have 50 top keywords in there that are highly relevant, I know some people say, oh, you need to take thousands of keywords. And I feel like that's just way too much. That's somebody who has no idea how to focus. You need to make sure that you have your main focus keywords in your title and in your first 3 bullet points, and then obviously in your search term. That's the most important. Everything else obviously can also help you to rank organically on lower search volume and lesser search volume keywords. But the most important keywords, which can't be 1,000, which has to be 20 to 50, that's the ones you're going to focus in your listing, and those are the ones you're going to focus on in your PPC. So you got to write this list. Once you do the work, work your way through this great Excel sheet, then you do the work once, right? Because the same list you will need also when you create your PPCs and stuff to keep track on them. So here you have a nice little list of a ton of keywords that all sound very similar. So what we do is we copy them, download selected keywords, and I'm downloading them. Then hopefully they open up. And then you can see even the score here, which is pretty good. So it actually also tells you what has a good score, which is generally something like the CPR, the search volume. Is it a good keyword? Is it not a good keyword? So you can open this. What I do here, you can go through them. So what I do, I'm just going to copy all of them. Oops, it's a big list. So it's way more than Helium 10 would give you on a free plan. All right, so I'm exporting my magnet list to Excel. I will export my cerebral list to Excel. So I'm going to do that. And my keyword tool, I also already exported to Excel, which is great. So what I do have here now is three different lists. And just to make it a bit easier, because it's obviously going to be a lot otherwise, you just compare, obviously, the keywords you're going to have. I have a lot because I'm on a premium plan, but you will only have 50 keywords here on Magnet and 50 on Cerebro. If you do this multiple times a day, it's like two times each day for like a few days, you're going to get a lot of different keywords, and you can actually pop them all into one list and then remove the duplicates so you don't have the same ones over and over again. And then you will create a final list, which this one here is from Keyword Dominator, and you can also create another few lists using this one here. That Sona belongs to Salix, great tool. They have a lot of nice blog posts as well if you're interested in that. And I'm just going to copy that ASIN here again. So that works a little bit like Cerebro. And hopefully shows us some great keywords. So here we go. A lot of other great keywords. It doesn't show us as many, which is a bit annoying. And then it tells you here, what is it, what is what for, gives you frequency. Don't worry too much about these ones, but these are not too bad. Download, most likely you will have to, I don't even want to click it because it's probably going to get me to the upgrade file again. But that's another one. So you could just copy these ones and pop them to your Excel sheets. And here's another one, which I also really like, is Keyword Tool IO. Really, really works well. So you just use any of those. So it also helps if you're doing later on some Google advertising or want to write some onto YouTube stuff or for whatever, really. We go to Amazon, obviously. And then here we type in pet hair remover. And as you can see, it looks very similar to Helium 10. It gives you very similar keywords, all going to be very similar, which is probably one of the most important things you can have. You cannot see the search volume, the trend or anything, but that's okay, because if you already have this one, so you have some sort of idea what you're looking for, you can see that, okay, they're all going to come up with the same, which is awesome. So you still will be able to create a really, really good keyword list. And it's just for an example. So you will be able, like, these are all the phrases. So that's what we're looking for. This is what I'm calling a keyword, not the inner word, not the individual word. So don't worry about the word frequency. We don't care about pet or hair or remover or for or couch. We don't care for those. We care for pet hair remover for couch. That is an awesome keyword phrase. So if yours is actually not for a pet, so to brush the pet, remove the pet's hair from the pet, but remove the pet's hair from your couch or from your clothes or from carpets or cars or whatever. And that's what you have to type in. This is highly relevant. It's a nice long phrase and it will be way easier to rank for this one compared to just the pet hair remover. All right. So you're going to have a nice keyword list, around 50 keywords, highly relevant. If you're not sure if a keyword is relevant for you, go to Amazon, type it in, pet hair remover for couch. And then you see, okay, are 80% of this, of these products here, are they what you're selling? Yes or no? If they are, great. Then that's a relevant keyword for you. You won't have the CPR in most cases, but you can still check here, the higher the reviews on each of these ones, the harder it's most likely to go and rank for it. So you want to have a nice mix of keywords that are a bit longer, a bit shorter. So that's kind of how you have to go about it if you don't want to use a tool. And then you create your little keyword list here and use your own little listing optimizer, which I will show you in another video. So I hope that makes sense. Just try a lot of things out. Even if you if you're thinking about signing up for a tool, test them all on the free trial. Most of them will offer you a free trial. Either you can do 20 top searches, you can do search for 2 weeks completely and can use all tools. There's a lot of things that can do. Test them all, including Helium 10 and all these tools. Also go and check Google, the Google Google Trends can help you to decide which keyword is maybe a better keyword than another one. So if you don't want to sign up for anything, you can just simply go here. My new asset, I don't know, a pet hair remover. Oops. Pet hair remover. Just gotta go for the US. There we go. And you can compare versus pet hair remover for couch. Then you can obviously see here what the difference is in search volume, right? So that's the main keyword. That's another keyword. You can also compare it with another one, pet hair for car. Yeah, then you can see that for car is actually a bit better than for couch. So great, great tools, all free. Give it a shot. Tell me what you think about it. I'm going to show you how to use your own little listing optimizer in the next one. So stay tuned.